The cooperative movement in Kenya dates back to 1908, when the first cooperative society was formed. World over, cooperatives are intended to address the plight of the poor segments of the society. The agenda is usually to empower citizens to realize their socio-economic capacities using locally available resources. A cooperative society brings together people with a common purpose of pooling resources for mutual economic and social benefits. They indeed organize economic platforms that help them cooperate out of poverty. In Kenya today, the cooperative movement has surpassed the primary objectives such as self-help and social responsibility. It has transformed its huge economic outfits that play a key role in the general development of the country. Cooperatives are found virtually in every sector of Kenya's economy. They provide an important framework for mobilization of resources. The movement continues to offer employment to thousands of people. It also provides opportunities for self-employment. Indeed, a significant number of Kenyans draw their livelihood either directly or indirectly from cooperatives. Currently, the cooperative movement in Kenya has over 9 million membership. Kenya has been a success story as far as the development of cooperatives is concerned. Cooperatives have a pivotal role in poverty alleviation and wealth creation. They are recognized by the government to be a major contributor to national development.
Our corporate movement is charged with the responsibility, among others, of supporting agriculture in food production. As we go into the future, I see our role as actively being involved in the irrigation sector. As you are aware, rain-fed agriculture is no longer reliable in Kenya. We, working with the Ministry of Water and Irrigation and Agriculture, have developed cooperatives around the irrigations as a way of contributing towards food security. We have in the past been very involved in value chain because we found that the farmer needed to be supported at all levels. A major contribution for us is through the credit. We found credit was missing in the chain that would encourage the farmer to produce sufficient food. Through our Sacco movement, we are able to reach many farmers at the grassroots level.
The greatest contribution of cooperatives to Kenya's social economic sector cannot be overemphasized. Here, the financial cooperatives, savings and credit Saccos hold substantial savings drawn mostly from members' deposits.
Vision 2030 is just an improved life, improved lifestyle. Everybody with access to better medical facilities, everybody with access to good schooling, good education, everybody with access to good shelter, the basic things that we even addressed at independence. So when we are talking about savings in the country, the savings culture, which we've been trying to promote, particularly among the youth, we find that there are a lot of things you're able to achieve in terms of Vision 2030. We're talking about things like housing. If you look at the teachers' circles, they have enabled their members to build modern houses, to have modern kind of lifestyles, which they could not have had if they were on their own and acting as individuals. So the civics culture can be replicated, not just in housing, but in another activity. And that is happening in transport. That is happening in what you call border industry, where you find our young people are earning on average 500 shillings a day. And 500 shillings a day, if you multiply that by 30 days in a month, there are very few employed people who make the kind of money that the border people are making. The only difference is that in the past, when they were not in a cooperative, they didn't know how to save that money. And therefore, the income from their activities went to wastefulness.
The ministry acts also as for networking, linking us with the other cooperatives of the world. Yeah, We feel very proud when we go for international conferences, when our minister is introduced that Kenya as a fully-fledged ministry for cooperative development.
There's evidence that financial cooperatives provide an alternative channel to ordinary people to improve their quality of life and meet their basic needs at affordable costs. Members can get a better and more secure return on their savings and access to loans at affordable interest rates. Cooperatives also help create more equitable growth. They help make work better for poor people by generating economies of scale, increasing access to information, and improving bargaining power. Cooperatives do provide an opportunity for self-determination and empowerment of poor people. They foster a culture of good citizenship and enable their members to have a voice and participate in a democratic process, thus having empowering development effects beyond their economic benefits. The government, in recognition of the important role played by Saccos, enacted the Cooperative Societies Act to regulate and oversee the development of cooperatives. The Ministry of Cooperatives Development and Marketing is the official agency for coordinating cooperatives in Kenya. The Saccos Societies Regulatory Authority, SASRA, is a semi-autonomous government agency under the Ministry of Cooperative Development and Marketing.
Now, this authority is just like Central Bank that regulates the banks. The authority is under the law, is the one that licenses. For the first time, Saccos must apply for a license, just like banks apply for license. But you see, they are still cooperatives. But when it comes to the license, they have to apply for this license from SASRA. Why was it necessary to set up the Saccos Regulatory Authority? One, of course, was because of the growth that I've talked about. Number two is to build confidence in Saccos business. You know, build confidence among members, build confidence among stakeholders.
Despite that fundamental social-economic role of Saccos in Kenya, most of the savings and credit cooperatives are faced with a number of challenges.
We have the challenge of capacities. Another challenge which as a Sacco we are facing is the capital. You see, most of our clients are the low-income earners, tea growers, coffee. We've tried to move out of the small earners from the tea growers. We are going into the business community so that we can be able to mobilize savings.
The agribusiness department, we are giving loans to dairy farmers. We're giving loans to farmers that would like to plant tissue culture bananas. And we want to tell Kenyans this is a big milestone that Wakenya Pamoja Sacco has been able to make. Of course, we thought we should open up and tell our members to ensure that, you know, in terms of food security, it is well with them.
Vision 2030 aims at marketing Kenya as an industrialized middle-income country that provides high-quality life for its citizens. The vision's three pillars are economic, social, and political. The cooperative movement is an important instrument in the achievement of the ambitious goals spelled out in the Vision 2030 socio-economic blueprint.
The way you do business is not the traditional way the Sacco do business, where you save for 6 months before you can be able to get a loan. Because as we reasoned and said, no person will wait for you for 6 months. And therefore, we came up with a product where upon joining the Sacco, save for 1 month, then you can be able to obtain a huge loan to an extent of 3 million. That is the first of its kind in the Republic of Kenya.
And we have also encouraged our members to save. We have different products which aim at increasing the members' savings. For example, we have a retirement plan, a saving, which is known as Maisha Refu, in which is a long-term saving product, and this has really assisted us in meeting the loan demand.
Most of our loans, they take a very short time. We have so many instant products. We have emergency loans, which you just come and put your application. It is normally assessed by the various officers. Then it is just it's an instant product, as I said, so you get it within the same day as your application.
We have been able to finance our operations, one, through the remittances that we receive from the employers as a result of giving loans. Two, our members normally contribute monthly towards their deposits. The other thing is we try as much as possible to get deposits from our customers, that is in the FOSA section. In addition, we have partnered with other financial institutions to be able to cope up with the high competition within our operations. And lastly, we have also partnered in other institutions by way of acquiring external facilities with them.
It is recognized by the government that the cooperative movement can be a major catalyst to national development and play a crucial role in the attainment of the goals of Vision 2030.
When we launched our service charter, it was seen to be a step forward. When we developed our website, it was a step forward. And then we also managed to get funding from ILO of Africa. For ILO of Africa is actually after developing cooperatives, especially those cooperatives which will develop to SMEs and which will create employment and all that. And we were a part of that. When we were given the challenge fund as a capacity building, then that is when we received recognition, because those people were voting for us and the international people. The quick response, how we applied and how we qualified, is what prompted those people to realize we can do something.
Our microcredit basically deals with the customers who comes to our front offices. We deal with the individual customer. We deal also with the groups which are being trained by our members of staff who are based at the FOSA section. They always move to the field to mobilize, do an outreach and promotion. When the members come together to form groups, they are being trained on the requirements that they need to fulfill before they get a loan from Baringo Teachers.
In Baringo Teachers, we are fully embraced ICT, and we use a system called Finance Tree software, which is basically a Saccos software. The system was partly developed here and it's being used by many Saccos.
Cooperatives have empowered their members to have command over resources. This is what Kenya requires to enhance agricultural productivity. Overall, the major benefits that Kenyans get through cooperatives include creation of employment, generation of income, and acquisition of property. Cooperatives also serve as agents of social and economic change, therefore are vibrant civil society actors.